The application said, what is your race? White, black, Asian, other.
But what do I choose? Who am I associated with? I wonder if it's that simple. I'm 17, biracial, born in LA County. I went to high school, then college, from being many to one, then to being none. Why can't I be everything and nothing at the exact same time?
It's not easy to know what is true for you or me. I feel and see and hear you, biracial others. Hear you.
Hear me.
We too. You.
Me talk on this page. Who am I? What makes me me? I like to laugh, smile, live, and be free. I like to joke, love, and sing life through music. Beyonce, Alicia Keys, or Rihanna. I guess being biracial doesn't make me not like the same things as people who aren't biracial. So will my page be other as I write? Being me, it will not be other, but it will be a part of you, society. But why should I choose? Sometimes I just want to say no, but we are, that's true. Society asks,
what are you?
Just because you're other on a piece of paper doesn't mean you're other in society.
You are you.
You're what you accomplish. You're not defined by a label.
I set my garden on fire, a place full of peace and full of desire, all in an attempt to cull inspiration from the chaos of it all. Estoy bien, mama. I'm fine, it was an accident. Is this real poetry, or are these just my thoughts? I need to ignite more, maybe then it'll all come to me. No, mama. I need to burn it down. It's all part of the process. The scorched sage and singed lavender. Nothing remains but sweet smoke in their place. Hey, mama, I need more metaphors. Do I incinerate the jasmines too? Frantic to finish, I set the last bush ablaze, the white roses lost in the haze. My garden is gone, leaving only ash, its single trace. Beautiful, isn't it, Mama? Do you know what that all means? But Mama is much too forgiving. The neighbors felt sorry for me, because I would never write again. All the masterpieces I would write in my garden, even after turning them to ash, all I could find was one. Look, Mama, are you proud of me? It's finally done.
This message has been initiated by National Alert and Warning Authorities for the City of California at approximately 4:30 p.m. Don't listen to them, don't listen to them.
To mail. Subjects needed for experiment.
The ears are the fastest way to the brain, 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 the brain.
Yeah. happening here? Whoa.
Subject. Terminated. Results have been recorded.
Mariposas para mi familia.
Para mi hermano, gracias por darme la paciencia para tratar con los demás. Por ti he ganado resistencia.
Para mi madre, gracias por darme una piel más gruesa.
Para mi padre, gracias por guiarme, por darme la inteligencia y la fuerza. Porque de ti no tengo miedo de seguir mis sueños.
Para mi abuela, gracias por enseñarme a ser cariño y honesto. Porque de ti tengo las habilidades para ayudar a los necesitados.
Para mi abuelo, gracias por regalarme los recuerdos felices de la infancia. Porque de ti tengo una sonrisa en mi rostro.
Mi familia me ha dado las herramientas y usé esas herramientas para hacer alas. Alas que me llevaran volando mis sueños. Gracias.
Thank you.
Prepare to experience inner wisdom and serenity in 17-syllable increments. Staffku.
Staffku!
Munching on Cheetos. Got to add in the hot sauce. Can't touch my classwork. Stop. Be still. Listen. Breathe in. Hold it. Now breathe out. It's almost summer. It is Monday night, and like a magnetic field, I will do no work.
This has been Staffku.
Staffku!
Do you ever stop to think about the funerals you have to attend? Flowers you have to drop?
Roses or lilies. Carnations are in season, but they prefer daisies.
Wonder how many black dresses you'll have to wear before the moon falls. Wonder how many handfuls of dirt you will toss.
How many songs begin to change meaning? How many ballads will you start dreaming of?
Stare at forget-me-nots and tiny baby's breath. Knowing in your heart of hearts, flowers wilt, life blooms. Humans are but mortals in a never-ending cycle of rebirth.
How many tears will you shed? Will you yell, rage, shut down, and blank out?
Will you walk by cemeteries in morning light? Do you ever wonder and think of the names soon to be etched in stone? And when you see vases, do you ever wonder what color looks best with ash gray?
What colors do you think of when you think of death? Will it be blood red and midnight black? The whites and all shades of the moon? The silver of crosses and the gold of earrings and grays of the clouds?
Or earthy greens and browns, the color of the soil in which you bury your soul? And the orange tones of the sun shining through the leaves?
Or will it be the color of your skin paling in grief? The blood in your fingernails from the hangnails you peel.
The pink of your lips chewed raw, your sniffling nose, your breaking heart. Do you ever think of what lace you will wear to the funeral? Of the eulogy you'll give, the coffins that will leave you bankrupt and broken?
May you stand in your room and look in the mirror and wonder what they will bury you in. The earrings you'll wear in the gilded casket. The color of your nails as they burn your essence.
And wonder, do they know you prefer daffodils to roses and lilies? Do they remember your name?
Do you ever think of the funerals you'll attend?
Thank you.
It has been prized by Americans since the establishment of the United States, as seen with the Constitution and its Fourth Amendment.
This amendment intends to defend Americans from random and unreasonable intrusions through the establishment of privacy.
Businesses take advantage of our vulnerabilities, like when people search for, I need money for groceries, or I need money for rent.
And the ads in return they get are predatory payday loans. Sometimes they even intrude on more serious searches, like, how do I get my crush to like me?
We are outside!
Yes, and today we will be interviewing some fellow Americans to see how they feel about their privacy rights being violated. Oh my god, there are some fellow Americans! Fellow Americans, have you ever been exploited by a big business?
No.
Have you ever been targeted by embarrassing ads?
Oh my gosh, yes, this just happened to me. I keep getting deodorant ads.
Oh my gosh. I've also been targeted by embarrassing ads.
So have I. I've been getting back knee ads. Who knows me?
I've got a foot cream ad bombarding me every day.
Oh, that's horrible.
Maintaining privacy rights conflicts with the collection of medical data that can lead to progress in many areas of medicine, such as dividing potential cancer cells and increasing the speed at which radiologists process scans. Though there is an overabundance of data being collected through doctor visits, data scientists are unable to access this data because it would violate the patient's privacy rights. This data could be holding the needed information to cure life-threatening diseases, on top of breakthroughs scientists could make with the more knowledge of fatal diseases. The treatments produced from the current data are not compatible with all patients, and the data is limited in diversity.
We are back at Carter High School, ready to film one of the teachers, Ms. March.
See if she likes her privacy rights. Ms. Marks, do you enjoy your privacy rights?
Yeah. Well, would you give them up to save thousands of children with cancer?
The most profound reasons for limiting privacy rights is their conflict with safety. One homicide case revealed that pregnant woman Brittany Mills was murdered by the killer, who the police believed identity was contained on her device, which Apple refused to unlock. Hi, I'm working with the police department, and I really need you to open up this phone so we can continue our investigation about a woman who was recently murdered.
Oh, that's not your phone? Well, I can't. I can't do that. A whole privacy thing with our customer, you know.
Yes, but the only evidence to who our killer is on this phone, and she was pregnant and murdered.
Yeah, well, here at Apple, we don't unlock our customers' phones without consent, you know, because of privacy.
Okay. When the Founding Fathers wrote the Constitution, their idea of privacy very much differed from ours.
The Founding Fathers wanted people to feel safe in their homes. They were not concerned about the spread of information.
Together, I ran out.
And now, prepare yourself once again to get 17 syllables closer to understanding the universe. Staffku.
Staffku!
Math is fun to do. Statistics is better, too. I like doing math. Delicate flowers, all work, no consequences. Weep for the future. Beep goes the bell. Stagnant students, no movement, all tardies, bummer.
Once again, this has been Staffku.
Staffku!
Hey. Hey! Can you hear me? You can? Great! Finally a friend! Okay. As you can see, I'm a wall. Weird, right? Well, to your surprise, we're conscious too. Just listen to these accounts from other walls. And here, we see a wall struggling with a family with many kids. Let's see what he has to say.
I hate kids so much. Like, they're smelly, they're annoying, they spit on me. Like, I can't take it anymore. I haven't had a night's rest in, like, so long, okay? And I just need a break, okay? I just need a break. Do you know how much work I put into these kids? Do you know how much work I put into not harming them? Like, you know, I just want to get to my breaking point sometimes. Like, sometimes I wish I had the body of a person just so I could just grab these little pests by the throats and then I could just...
Whoa. Okay, that's enough of that. Moving on. Here's a wall from, Mexico?
No sé por qué me hablas. Ni siquiera puedo hablar inglés.
Okay, well, that was a failure. Maybe the next houses will be a success. Who knows?
The parents here don't listen to their kids. They say it's all fake and part of their imagination. But I know the truth. I've seen it. Every night, the kids complain of a monster that comes out of the closet to come and eat them. And every night, the kids are lucky and get scared away because it's very easily scared of lights and noise. But I fear that one day, one night, the kids will be especially tired, and they won't wake up in time. And I would be powerless to do nothing but listen as their terrible screams just fill the room. And I would be powerless to do nothing except wait for their little screams to slowly fade away.
Okay, moving on. For our last one, we have a love-stricken fool. Let's see what they have to say.
Her eyes glisten like a thousand shining stars, and I'm here blinking in the starlight. I love the way her posters just hide away her nail holes and her paint chips. Unfortunately, we are here imprisoned in our solitude on the opposite sides of this very room forever.
I think he spent too much time reading romance novels, but I think my point here has been proven. Be careful what you do around walls, because if these walls could talk, they would.
Hmm. He stood mesmerized by the blinding glare of sequins on her blouse. Her captivating golden eyes placed him in a trance. The sticky city stars stuck on the vast expanse of jet black only phased as a backdrop to her. He stumbled mindlessly in the milky haze as she danced, her silky, soft whispers like an anesthetic. She giggled as his clammy, sweat-drenched hands reached out to her. His weak smile, a pathetic disguise for the grim outcome surely to come. The rhythm racing through his frail, feeble body. The feeling coursing through his veins, an extension on her divinity. Had it been a minute, 2 minutes, an hour, time was frozen in the artificial world they created together. His eyes glazed in a thick glare of secondhand smoke, toppling around the room the closer on the edge had seemed. The sky turned red and wet. As he danced closer to the edge, her delicate, soothing touch grazed him once more before he met with the cold, wet concrete below. His icy, motionless body forever resting in the endless fork bliss she had given him. Her pathetic recount of the grisly events of that night prior only made it easier to find justice for his cold-blooded murder. The court finds the defendant guilty.
I hope you get fired today for being late.
Why are you always so mean to me? Didn't you choose to be my gremlin?
Where'd you get that idea? I was assigned to you, unfortunately.
Whatever. Just don't bug me today, okay?
Fine.
I'm so sorry I'm late. I just had so many things to deal with and, you know, it's gremlins, am I right?
Oh, yeah, no, that's fine. But I'm sorry. Did you say gremlin?
Well, yeah.
I'm sorry. Do you have a kid or something? I mean, don't get me wrong. I understand how annoying they can be, but I don't think it's exactly appropriate to refer to them as gremlins, considering we work in a school, you know, with children.
No, I don't have any children. I'm referring to the gremlin who's on your shoulder when you're 14.
Excuse me?
You've never had one? Mr. Bishers, have you ever had a gremlin?
Gremlin?
Yeah, it appears on your shoulder when you're 14.
No. What does that even mean?
Marilyn here thinks she has a gremlin on her shoulder that talks to her and tells her what to do.
Well, I never said it tells me what to do, actually.
Bet I do.
That's hilarious. There's no way you have a gremlin on your shoulder.
Well, I thought everyone had one.
If you have this so-called gremlin, then why can't I see it?
Well, he says that no one but the gremlin, no one but the owner can see it, I'm sorry.
So you just talk to this thing?
Well, he says it's not proper etiquette to do it in public, but yeah.
Okay, so I'm gonna go back over there, and you should go get some help, because that is not normal.
Yes, I agree, and we have a meeting with one of your students, so let's go.
Coming, hi, this is Marilyn Lawrence. I just wanted to schedule an appointment with Dr. Roberts. Yeah. Thank you, that's fine. Okay, perfect. Thank you. Okay. You too. Okay.
You shouldn't have done that.
And you shouldn't exist.
Cancel the appointment.
No, I should go.
And do it. You have to.
It's not normal. No one else has a gremlin.
I don't like it, so cancel it.
You said you wouldn't bug me today.
Well, I lied.
Stop disturbing me.
You're the disturbance in this relationship.
Whatever. Just go to sleep, Grimmy.
Don't call me that!
Sorry. Hi, I'm here to check in. My name is Marilyn Lawrence.
Marilyn. Oh yeah, Dr. Roberts is ready to see you now.
Hi, Miss Lawrence. What brings you here today?
Well, I kind of have a gremlin on my shoulder.
A gremlin? Well, interesting. Can you elaborate on that for me, please?
He talks to me and he tells me what to do, so, you know, my coworker said it wasn't normal, so I just wanted to get everything checked out.
Okay. Well, we'll definitely be needing to do a couple more sessions after this because having a gremlin on your shoulder is not normal. Okay, Marilyn. As you know, we have done many of these sessions in order to find out information on your situation, and I have gotten results back leading to the conclusion that you, Marilyn, have schizophrenia. That is why you keep having these hallucinations of a gremlin on your shoulder, telling you what to do and constantly putting you down.
No, Marilyn, he has to be lying to you. I'm real. You can see and speak to me, so I have to be real. I told you she was just spreading lies. We need to get out of here.
Are you sure? Like, it has to be a stretch.
This gremlin is a hallucination that has altered the way you think, feel, and even behave. It may be hard to swallow in the moment, especially since you've lived with this gremlin for 10 years now. But you have schizophrenia, and this gremlin is a result of it.
Liar. I'm real. Don't listen.
Though it may be a late diagnosis, there is possible treatment that can help you. It usually consists of medication and a lot of therapy. Would you like to try it?
No! Why are you letting this garbage into your head? We have to go now before they brainwash you even more!
I'd have to.
I just said no. This won't help us at all. This will just make us grow apart, Marilyn. Do you want that? You couldn't live without me now. What are you doing? You can't take that. Let's just go to sleep, okay? We can work this out tomorrow. Don't be like that, baby.
Whatever. I'm going to bed.
You know if you take that, you're going to put me, I mean us, in danger. That garbage could destroy me. I mean us.
You don't even care about me. Just want control. Grimmy?
Thank you.
last time. Ready yourself for 17-syllable bite-sized nuggets of ultimate truth. Staffku.
Staffku!
Grams of beans, ground on 12 by Baratza. Ready for water. Flieger Schmetterling, verbreite deine Flügel. Die Zukunft ist deins. Yellow mist blocks path, sword, spells, talisman, or two. Roll, swing, dead again.
Once again, this has been Staffku.
Staffku!